So this is the way I put back the new lower table. So this has new bushings, the wishbone, if you put a new cake on it. So I've heard many people had issues putting back the ball joint because the table is very stiff, it cannot be lowered enough. So what I did is I removed a bolt from the strut assembly. I removed the bolt so I can swing it a little bit. And as you can see, I removed both the lower bolts from the strut. So this will make it much easier to put back the table. So be very, very careful with the cable. That's the ABS cable. Don't stretch it, so you'll be in trouble. Don't forget the small, what is that, a cover, a plastic cover over the shaft. So let's just, what I did is putting back first the shaft and the spindle. Fiddling. To get this spline on. Very much of this. All right. Having fun with it. Careful with the shaft, never left it suspend, or it may detach the CV joint by itself and then it's a mess. So always keep the shaft, keep it, well, don't let it suspend by itself, by its weight. So as you can see, look how easy it is to put back the ball joint. There we go, it's back. So next thing will be just the push a little bit and just securing a bit the ball joint. Push down the control arm with your weight. So it's really easy. Place the strut. There we go. Push it a little bit. And that's it. This goes the head towards the front of the car. So you have to place the bolt in the brake assembly. One. There you go. It's done. This would be the camber of the car. I usually set it this way to the max. Tighten the bolts. And yeah, my links are detached, but I will be just jacking up with the I'm gonna jack up all this and attach the link. And that's it. So good luck. That's the bolt I removed up there. It's easier. As you can see, new table and all the stuff.